Last video we talked about allocating memory and pages. Let's use this knowledge today to read and write another process's memory and even take a look at how to implement something like Cheat Engine. So, as I explained last time, each process has a page table associated that tells the CPU how to dereference pointers. Now, each process has its own unique mapping. This is also called virtual space. For some things, the operation system will reuse pages. For example, when loading a DLL, the operating system can load a DLL functions only once in RAM, regardless of how many processes use that functions. The mappings can and will probably still be different, but the addresses will point to the same place. Now, what happens if one process wants to read from another process's memory? Well, since they have different mappings, you can't just read from another process's memory. You have to ask Windows to copy the memory content in your own virtual space. Okay, so how can we do that in practice? Under day 8, in the repo associated with this course, I created a victim process. It has some data, and it will first print its address. Then, it will wait for us to press enter, and finally, it will print the content of the data inside an infinite loop. This will allow us to see if it was modified. Now, we will look at the hacker process that will attempt to modify the victim's memory. The first thing that we have to do is to find the victim process. And there are a few ways we can do this. I chose to find the process's ID using the process's name. So the process ID or PID is just a unique number assigned to each process. If you open Task Manager, you can take a look at each process's ID from there. I wrote this helper function to get it programmatically by program name. You don't have to understand how it works, but basically, I'm just iterating to all the opened processes and searching for the desired process name. Now, in order to read or write from another process's memory, we need a handle to that process. Luckily, it is not difficult to get that. We just have to call open process. The first parameter is a desired access, and we can just tell Windows to let us do whatever we want with our poor victim by specifying process all access. Now, of course, this would fail if you try to open a higher privileged process than your process, because then you could just DLL inject it and take over the victim's PC. So this is why there are so many flag options here, because Windows might allow you to specify some of them and might not allow you to use others depending on the process that you are trying to open. As always, you should be also taking a glance at the documentation on your own. The next parameter can be false, and finally, we can pass our PID. The functions return 0 on fail, which is strange because some other functions return invalid handle value. But anyway, we'll just check for this possible error. Now we can finally read and write to the process's memory. Read process memory does exactly what it says it does. The first parameter is the handle. Then, the address we want to read. This address is in the victim's memory space. I will just read it from the keyboard. Next, you have to pass a buffer for the data to be read into, and the size of that buffer. Finally, in the last parameter, Windows likes to report back to us the number of bytes read, as it happens in many other functions. But fortunately, we can pass null pointer here, and Windows will ignore it. Be careful, because not all functions allow you to pass null pointer for this parameter. Now, we print the data, and then we change it to 69 MAO. Write process memory has exactly the same parameters as the function above. Both functions return non-zero on success, and I say non-zero because the value returned is actually an int, not a bool. Yes, it looks strange, but keep in mind that this API has to also work for C, where you don't have bools. Let's test it. We first launch the victim. Let's copy the memory address and start printing the data. Now let's open the hacker process. Once I paste the memory address, you can see that the victim's data was changed. Okay, now there is still a problem here. Let's say you want to scan the process's memory. You could start reading to the process's memory, but that means searching for 2 to the 64 addresses. For reference, if you could scan 1 million addresses per second, it would take more than 500,000 years to scan all of them. Well, in practice, the virtual address space is smaller than that because it is useless for Windows to allow you to access that many addresses. So Windows doesn't use all the bytes for optimization purposes. But it is still a big number. So, how can you make something like Cheat Engine? Before I tell you that, I want to quickly congratulate you for making it this far into the tutorial series. We are two more videos away from finishing part 1, and don't forget that in part 2 we will learn to open our own window. So subscribe to not miss that out. Ok, so let's look again at this drawing here. This might give you a hint to what we can do to scan a process's memory. We have to ask Windows to tell us what are the pages of that process. Almost any address can be mapped by a process, but in practice, a process doesn't need terabytes of RAM, so only a few pages will be mapped. We can ask Windows to give us a list of those pages. In virtualscanner.cpp, I have done exactly that. The program starts like the hacker one. Here I am calling, however, the scan virtual pages function that was written by me. Let's see how it works. First, I'm getting the page size, as I did in day 7. We will use this to display stuff later. Next, I have to create this memory basic information struct. Scanning the virtual space of a process works like this. You have this function called virtualQueryX. Unlike virtualquery, virtualQueryX allows you to scan other processes' virtual space rather than just your own. This function gives you information about the next page's range, starting from the base address. So, for example, if I put the base address 0, the function will give me the first range of pages. And by range of pages, I mean contiguous pages that have the same flags. So if you allocate, let's say, 1 GB of memory, for example, Windows will give you some continuous pages to fill 1 GB of memory. Now, to scan the entire process, you have to call this function inside an infinite loop and increment the base size every time so you scan the next pages. And we will increment it by the region size. Now, remember about the page flags that I mentioned last video? We can check for these flags here. We want to search for pages that are committed and that are also read-write. Here, we will be able to find the program's variables. Finally, I will display the region information. To see how many pages are there, I will just divide the region size by the size of one page. As last time, I will first open the victim and then the virtual scanner. One interesting thing that you will notice is that, as expected, all of the pages are aligned in memory to the size of one page. Okay, now your homework is to try to use this knowledge to try to make something similar to Cheat Engine. Now I will give you quick tips. First, don't scan the memory for the value of 0, because there are many zeros in one process. Also, just focus on one data type, let's say int, and remember that the data will be aligned. So if you scan for ints, you can scan every 4 bytes. If you are still unsure how Cheat Engine works, check out this video about my Cheat Engine clone. But now, we will learn how to load a DLL.